Let us study a very important law in the magnetic induction section, that is Biot Savart's law. About this law we can write that this law gives the magnetic induction vector in surrounding of a current element. This current element is basically the term which is used for a small piece of a current carrying wire. Like say we are given with a wire carrying a current I. If we consider a small element of length dl in it, say this is the direction of dl vector along the direction of current. Then the small element which is carrying a current we can term as current element. Now due to this current element in the surrounding of this wire, by using right hand thumb rule we can find out the direction of magnetic induction. And say from this element at a point P which is located at a position vector r with respect to the current element located at an angle theta. If we wish to find out the magnetic induction by using right hand thumb rule, the direction of magnetic induction is inward, which we denote by cross in a circle. And say due to this element magnetic induction at point P is dB. Then this dB can be, magnitude of dB can be directly given by the magnetic induction due to moving charge we already studied. And in this situation, we can write it mu naught upon 4 pi qv sine theta by r square. If we wish to find out the total charges within the element of length dl, if we consider its cross-sectional area to be A, then the total number of free electrons into it will be dlan. So the charge contained within this element we can write as nadl. And multiplied by it can be written as V sine theta divided by R square. This is the expression for magnetic field due to the moving charges within this wire. So in this situation we know that we need to multiply one charge of electron over here also. So in this situation any V can be written as current density multiplied by area will become the total current. So magnetic induction in this situation we can write as mu naught upon 4 pi NEV. V can be taken as drift velocity. So any VD can be written as current density multiplied by area as the current. So it can be written as IDL sine theta by R square. So this is the magnetic induction which we obtain by using Biot Savart's law or the method by which we have calculated the magnetic induction due to a moving charge in its surrounding. And it can also be expressed vectorially. Here we can vectorially write as dB vector is mu naught upon 4 pi I dl sine theta. In the situation dl is along the direction of current and r vector is in the direction of point P. The angle between these is theta. This can be written as I dl cross r divided by r cube. Here also I have written it in the similar way as we have written the magnetic field vector for a moving charge. Here the direction of dl cross r will be in the direction into the plane of this paper, that is in the direction of magnetic field. So just be careful about the two results we obtained, this for the magnitude and this the vector magnetic induction in the surrounding. So using this we can find out the total magnetic induction at point P, which is due to the whole wire, can be written as B vector is integration of dV vector, which is integration of mu naught upon 4 pi I dl cross r by r cube. And the limits will apply according to the actual shape and configuration of the current carrying wire.